Hey friends, did you know that you can create serverless event flows based on activity in your Azure Cosmos DB database? A new version of the Cosmos DB bindings extension for Azure Functions is now available in preview. Matias Quaranta is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Matias and we're going to talk about a new version of the Cosmos DB bindings extension for Azure Functions. How are you, sir?
Pretty good. Thanks again, Scott, for the invitation. It's always a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, so I understand that you can now trigger Azure Functions based on things that are happening in your Cosmos DB database.
That's correct. We already have a functions integration that allows users to create bindings and triggers to their database and containers. And we are releasing a new version that will enable more interesting things like wearing Azure AD identities instead of connections and strings, performance improvements, and a bunch of other stuff that we'll talk in the show.
Yeah, in the past, I felt a little bit kind of uncomfortable about how I had to deal with my connection strings. And I really just want to think about the identity of the user and use Azure AD if I can. So it'll be nice to see how you've improved that.
That's for sure. I totally understand that from the security perspective, it feels a bit awkward to, have those keys laying around. You never know who can snoop and get them. Why don't we start and take a look at the code and we can see it in action.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, so as you see, I have my functions application. The only thing I did was bump the Azure Functions extension for Cosmos DB to our new version. You see that it's still in preview. We'll talk about it a bit at the end. But for now, it's basically just pull whatever is the latest version. Once we do that, we can just go back to our function, similar to what we've worked in the past with the current extension. I'm using the Cosmos DB trigger. And probably the first big difference that we'll note is that the connection is no longer called connection string. It's now a connection. And the reason is that we right now support not only connections and strings. I could keep using connections and strings. Why not? But we also support Azure AD integrations, or also known as managed identities. So in order to get this working, I already went ahead and deployed this function to Azure just to make it easier and faster. Mm-hmm. But basically, what I'm telling Azure Functions is my connection will be identified by this name, Cosmos DB. Then I went to my Azure Functions, which is already deployed in Azure. And there is a configuration section called Identity. Once we enable this, this basically creates an Azure identity or a managed identity in my Azure AD tenant and gives me the ID of that identity. Basically, this identity now represents the function. It's telling Azure AD, this is a function, and this is the identity that represents it as an entity in Azure AD. Once that is exposed and I have the object ID, the next step that I can do is Cosmos DB now supports Azure AD integration, not only for functions, but for any other flows. And I can create my own role definitions. There is a list of different permissions that I can give. For example, I could create a role definition that can only read data, but cannot write, or that has only access to a particular subset of my databases and not others. Cosmos DB comes with two predefined roles, one that is data reader and one that is data contributor or read and write. So for the purpose of this demo, what I did was I basically took and used the role definition for the data contributor, because maybe I want to do other things in the function, like maybe write some documents somewhere else. The way right now to wire this is basically through CLI. So once I have the ID of the function and the role that I want to execute, there are a couple of Azure CLI commands that I can run, which are basically this is how to create a custom role. And there is a way for you to say, this is basically the snippet. This is the accountant that I want to give access to. This is the ID of the role definition that I want to use. And then this would be the ID of my managed identity in my function app. And I can just run this on Azure CLI. What it will do is it will provide or give permission to my function app to access my Cosmos DB account with the permissions that I'm already defining.
Right. So you're assigning a role to an identity. You're saying it is my role, my job as this function to update this little table or read this little thing. You give that role a name and then you assign it to the identity. And we don't think about connection strings anymore. And we're really using the power of Azure the way it's meant to be used.
Exactly. So basically, once I already did that, and I enabled this function manage identity to access my databases, the next thing that I need to do is how to set the configuration. So in Azure Functions, there is a way to tell the function or the configuration of the function that I want to use manage identities. This is basically how I would do it. Is I need to set the connection name prefix, which is, in this case, Cosmos DB. Mm-hmm. And there is a underscore credential that I need to put as manage identity. And I do this everything on the function configuration. So I would have in this function configuration a part that says Cosmos DB, because that's my prefix, the one that I'm setting on the function, mm-hmm. underscore credential. And this has a value of manage identity. This is telling Azure Functions, for this connection that is called Cosmos DB, I want to use a credential, an Azure AD credential, but I want to use the manage identity of this function app. And the second configuration that I need to add is part of Cosmos DB particular or individual configuration, which is the account endpoint that I want to access with this configuration. This would be the account endpoint for the account that I just gave permissions to my function app. So in the case of my example, what I'm saying is I want to use manage identity, and the account endpoint is this particular account that I just ran the CLI for and I gave permissions for. Once I do that, and I deploy my function, this is already giving the function access to my Cosmos DB instance without me putting any connection strings anywhere. This not only brings improvements in the security, because there is no way for me to leak these credentials anywhere and no one can steal them and access my data. I also don't care about refreshing or rolling these keys in the event that they might be leaked, because there is no potential of leakage. So once I have this already deployed, I'm going to hook into the function's logs. So I should be able to see whatever I'm outputting in my function, which is very simple. I just wanted to do something simple for you. It will just print whatever document is being detected as change in the function. So basically, if I come to my Cosmos DB database and I add a new document, let's call it Hello Scott, and I save, I should see the invocations and the logs here.
Okay, let's wait and see.
So here is the invocation. I totally missed the logs. Okay, I'll refresh the screen just in case there is some authentication thing going on.
Okay.
And I'll write another document.
So while you're doing that, so a new document has been created in Cosmos DB. So that is an event that we are subscribed to. It could be an update. In this case, it was a create. And mm-hmm. we saw Cosmos get that post and receive it. And then we can see here we're going to connect to the logs. And then you can see you're now connected to the log streaming service. So now we're actually connected and have a persistent connection to the log stream.
That's correct. So all let's right. come again and say.
Now, that doesn't mean the log didn't happen. It just means we didn't see it before for our exactly. friends that are following along at home. So now we do our post, we hear our save, and then there you go. Look at that.
Yep. So basically, this function is accessing and listening for events on my Cosmos DB account mm-hmm. without any connections to strings. That's, I think, the biggest selling point of this new extension. But it comes with other new interesting things. Can I show it to you?
Yeah, let's see it.
Awesome. So going back to the function, this new version comes with, we are actually using our latest .NET SDK underlying the function extensions. That comes with a really high number of performance improvements. We've done a really extensive job during the past couple of years to improve performance. So all the operations for the trigger and for the bindings will be faster than the previous version of the extension. Yeah. There is one key point that is super interesting is previously with the trigger, you were limited in terms of what's the type of document that you receive. In the previous version, you would get something like a type called document, which was a generic property bug of JSON properties that it was exposed in the previous SDK version. There was a lot of users that didn't want to use document because it's just a generic property bug. They wanted to use their own business type or business classes. So what they had to do is basically they would have to take the input, serialize it as a raw string, and then take that raw string and deserialize it into their own business types. All that double, triple deserialization, it's obviously a performance penalty. So now with the new extension, you can just use whatever type that you want that maps to whatever business or user flow that you have. And what we'll do is we will take the raw JSON that is coming from the service and we'll deserialize into your type, whatever it is. So you don't have to pay the cost of double serialization if you want to handle the data in your own custom types.
That's really cool. Yeah. So you call them a POCO, a plain old CLR object, a POCO object for our friends that are following along at home, means that this is a .NET SDK. So it's a native SDK. So it feels like .NET because it is .NET. So you just get an object that's shaped the way you want the object to be, which is really great. Right. And then you have a generic read-only list, which is using the .NET generic support. So it feels very comfortable. And then you don't have to think about serializing and deserializing and just massaging data. It looks like Cosmos is going to do it all for us along with Azure Functions.
Yep, it removes a bunch of performance pitfalls that we had before. And that leads me to my last point, which is serialization again, but a bit more advanced. Now, our latest .NET SDK uses Newton's of JSON as a default serialization engine. We know that system.json is available, but maybe there are some other JSON serialization engines. And there should be an easy way for you to pick which is a serialization engine that you want to use, or that it's maybe the one that you use in your business or the one that you prefer. So what we enable with the new extensions is that there is a way for you to, using DI or dependency injection, define your own custom serializer. This custom serializer is an API that basically contains two methods, either from a stream or to a stream, and you can use your own custom implementation, just defining this serializer factory with an implementation that returns an implementation of the Cosmos serializer API. I could, like in this example, be using system.json as a serialization engine, replacing the Newton's of JSON that comes with default, or I could be using whatever other serialization engine that I have as a preference. So once I define this configuration in my function, I could then come back here and use the type with whatever serialization technology that I want, and we'll use your serializer to deserialize the raw JSON into your type. Again, I could be using Newton's of JSON, I could be using system.json, I could be using whatever you want, and it will just work.
Very cool. This is great. This sounds like a really great release because you're doing refactoring via subtraction, which means I don't have to think about my connection strings anymore. I don't have to think about serialization as much anymore. But if I want to think about serialization, you've given me full control now with a pluggable model to use any serializer that I want. So things are just getting better in Cosmos DB world with Azure Functions.
Exactly. I mean, it's all in giving users choice and meet users where they are. They can now have more freedom when they are working with our extension.
Fantastic. So this is using the latest Cosmos SDK. And where can folks go to learn about this information?
So right now, we are in preview. And the reason we are in preview is because some of you might be familiar with the Azure Functions model. You have different plans. There is consumption plan, there is app service plan, there is premium plan. For consumption plan, there is a scaling mechanism that dynamically will scale your function based on your needs. And the reason we are in preview right now is because we are still deploying that mechanism, that updated mechanism that will work with the new extension. But once we have that in the coming weeks, this will be completely out, and we should have new announcements in our Cosmos DB devlog, which you probably can find in devblogs.microsoft.com/CosmosDB. That will be the place where we normally write and announce these new releases. And if you are interested in seeing part of the V3 SDK, which is the one what we are using under the hood, that should be available in GitHub because it's open source. Yep. So this is completely open source. And if you have any future requests, you can certainly do them here. And we'll follow it along and make sure that you have whatever can help you with either your functions integrations or with your usage of the CosmosDB.net SDK.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you for the invitation. It's always a great pleasure. And I hope that this has been of help for everyone out there.
Absolutely. I am learning all about the Azure Cosmos DB extension for Azure Functions. It's been updated with some great new features that you can give a try to right now. And this has been another episode of Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.